Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today I'm going to be talking about the best way to learn Arabic as Malaysian. Arabic is one of the most beautiful and poetic language spoken by over 400 million people worldwide across 26 stunning and diverse countries. However, it's also undeniably one of the most difficult language to learn, particularly if you are trying to learn Arabic at home or online without a structured course or a teacher. But like any other language, if you are committed and open to trying different methods and techniques, mastery of Arabic is both possible and incredibly satisfying. There are many ways of learning Arabic language. Knowing the right way will help you to reach your desired target in shorter span of time. Different native speakers of several languages have different ways to learn a foreign language. The method used by a native English speaker is not the same as Malaysians use. This means every native speaker have different approach to learn Arabic language. This speech is based on my experience learning Arabic for almost 10 years in Malaysia and Egypt. Here are some tips that you can use in your journey to mastering Arabic language. Firstly, I want to talk about the importance of setting goals in your journey. Setting achievable and trackable goals is important. Before you do anything, make sure you get clear on why you want to learn Arabic. Having a clear why or purpose will help you in setting your goal. Maybe it's because you have plans to travel the region and want to be able to converse with the locals. Perhaps there's a specific country in the Middle East that you want to visit, or maybe you need to learn for work. Everybody's why is different. Get clear on yours and write it down somewhere. You will see it regularly. This will give you the sense of purpose you need to stay motivated and keep moving forward when things get tough. Having a clear why also will help you in choosing the suitable method in learning. For example, if you learn Arabic for communication, you may want to focus more on speaking practice and enriching vocabulary for daily use. Also, you can learn some Arabic dialect so that it's easier to blend in with Arabs. On the other hand, if you learn Arabic to understand the Holy Quran, the Hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or any Islamic books, you may need to focus on grammar and reading practices. Next, I will explain about the importance of learning Arabic grammar. Why do we learn Arabic grammar? In English, the word order determines the meaning of the sentence. The word order determines the meaning of the sentence, and hence, it is relatively fixed. However, Arabic is flexible when it comes to the word order. Two sentences can have the same order with the same vowels on the end of the words, and the meaning remains the same. Two sentences can have same word order with the same vowels on the end of the words, and the meaning remains the same. As an example, look up ayah 44 in Surah Al-A'raf. وَنَادَى أَصْحَابَ النَّارِ أَصْحَابُ الْجَنَّةِ. This ayah means the dwellers of paradise will call out the dwellers of the fire. And we can also swap the dwellers around, but the meaning would not change because the vowels ashabul jannah remain the same. The subject in Arabic sentence usually ends in dhamma, while the object ends in fatha, regardlessly of the word order. No matter how the word order is, it will give the same meaning. Knowing this helps the reader to understand who will be calling who in this ayah. I'm definitely sure, even if we ask native Arabic speaker, if they don't have basics in Arabic grammar, they can't tell which is which. Therefore, we need to study the Arabic grammar in order to have a full understanding of the language. Then I will explain about the importance of practice to master Arabic. Learning grammar of any language wouldn't make you fluent at it. What's more important than grammar is knowing how to construct sentences that grammatically correct in the language. and knowing how to express what you want to say in your daily life. To achieve this, you need a lot of practice. In these days, practicing Arabic is not that difficult. There are many tools or mobile applications that you can use in order to practice Arabic. For example, if you want to practice listening, you can use YouTube to watch videos and interesting contents in Arabic. You can also listen to radio or even watching news and documentaries through YouTube. On the other hand, if you want to practice speaking, social media application can help you to achieve this goal. You can make friends with Arabs, joining their Facebook group and talk about their common interests. For example, if you're interested in web design, you can join any web design group that made for Arabs and join their discussion. All of this will help you enrich your vocabulary and your skill in building sentences. Lastly, I will talk about choosing the right tips in learning Arabic. For conclusion, I want you to remember, there's no one-size-fits-all way to learn. And the most important thing is that your practice is tailored to why you are learning the language. Pick and choose the tips that work for you based on your why, your current level of Arabic, and how much time and effort you can commit to regular practice. I believe that learning foreign language increases our understanding of people who are different to us, making the world a more peaceful and tolerant place to live. That's all from me. Hope you enjoyed this video. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.